بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا. قد وقفنا أيها الإخوة عند الكتاب الثالث، we stopped at book 3 من العربية بين يديك. وقفنا كذلك في صفحة 11، we stopped at page 11 of book 3. وكذلك أيها الإخوة وقفنا عند النص المتعلق بهذا أو بهذه الصفحة، والنص في صفحة 387. We also stopped at the text that is that linked to the page 11, and it's page 387. ووقفنا عند كلمة يا ليتني، ووقفنا تحديدا نعم عند النون الوقاية، وكنت قد شرحت لكم معنى نون الوقاية. So نعم 12th line from the bottom approximately تقريبا، يا ليتني فيها جدع. ونون الوقاية أيها الإخوة حرف لا محل له من الإعراب. What means لا محل له من الإعراب؟ The علماء of grammar, they use that to show that it has no position in the إعراب. لا محل له من الإعراب، يعني it's not a فاعل, not مفعول به, not مبتدا, not خبر, just a حرف. So نون الوقاية is there to stop normally from, or to stop two sukuns from touching each other. Like I mentioned, كلمني, speak to me. So if you remove the noon and the meme before the noon has sukoon, and the ya also has sukoon, what is the damir muttasil, then you get iltiqa al-sakinin, that's not allowed in Arabic. So the noon is there to prevent that bi-idhnillah. So ya laytani fiha jada'un. ليت حرف ناسخ من أخوات إن، ومعناه التمني. Is meaning of ليت is hoping and wishing. And as you know, the difference between ليت and لعل, although they're both from the أخوات إن, is that ليت is wishing something what is impossible, although you really want it, but it's very hard or impossible. While لعل is also from أخوات إنا, is wishing and hoping something what is easy to get. It's not far from the hands, يعني it's easy to get. Okay, لعل is something what is easy to achieve. نعم, that's easy to achieve. While later is hard or impossible. نعم, نون الوقاية. ويا ضمير متصل مبني على السكون في محل نصب اسم ليتا. Okay, so anything that's مبني, you don't say منصوب, but في محل نصب, في محل رفع, في محل جر. And جدع is خبر ليتا, is خبر ليتا منصوب مرفوع, خبر ليتا مرفوع. So I wish I would be a jada in that. Okay, يعني in that time, يعني he, the ha goes back to, يعني يعني it's like time, to the time when the people will when the people, نعم, they will be mentioned after a bit. So he said, يا ليتني فيها جدع ليتني أكون حيا إذ يخرجك قومك. He said, I wish I hoped to be a jada'. I wished to be alive. يعني ليتني أكون حيا. So he wished to be alive. He wished to be a jada'. إذ means when. يخرجك قومك. When your people will expel you. When يعني the people will take you out from your homeland. He wished to be a jada' and he wished to be akuna hayyan, to be alive. So look, subhanallah, to the wish of Waraqah to Ibn Nawfal, old man, blind as well. He wished to be a jada' and he wished to be alive as well. It, when the people will expel the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. First of all, how did Waraqah ibn Nawfal knew that the people will take him out? As you know, he used to know the Hebrew language, the Hebrew writing, so he had knowledge of of the book in the past, the Torah or the Injil. So he read, and he knew what happened also to the Prophet or prophets before the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and how they did with the prophets who came with the message of a tawheed, of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. What they did with Nuh, how they mocked him while he was building the ship, and what they did with Ibrahim, and they put the fire to throw him in the fire, and what they did with other prophets as well. So he knew the enmity of the people of shirk and what they did with their prophets. So that's why he said that he wished to be a jada when the people will expel him. أولا أيها الإخوة, first of all, كلمة جدع هو مرادف لكلمة شاب. يعني جدع means شاب. يعني he wished to be a شاب بشين ألف با مشددة. A youngster. He wished to be a teenager, or you can say a youngster. When the Prophet will get expelled, so he could help him. Waraqah ibn Nawfal wanted to help the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So jada'un mithlu shabun. Okay. وجمعوا شاب شباب بدون شدة. شباب is youngsters. أما للمؤنث فشابة بالباء مشددة والتاء مربوطة. شابة is a youngster for female. والجمع شابات بالباء المشددة. شابات ألف تاء مفتوحة. أما جدع فجمعه جذاع. فجمعه جذاع بالجيم المكسورة والذال والدات ألف عين جداع. وهناك بعض أنواع من الجمع الأخرى. There are different types of جمع for the word جدع. So أولها, first of those جمع is جداع. وكذلك جذع, جيم ذا عين جذع. وكذلك جذيان, جذيان. وكذلك جذيان. Okay, so the difference between them two is the one has dhamma في على الجيم, والجمع الآخر جيم مكسورة. جذياع ألف نون, جذياع ألف نون. وهناك جمع آخر جذع. فهناك أنواع كثيرة من الجمع, و آخرها التي ذكرت, last one I mentioned, is جدع. Okay. And that is أخطأت في أمر واحد. جدع is not a plural of جدع. جدع is not a plural of جدع. So the الجمع جذاع, جذع, جذيان, and جذيانون. Okay, جذيانون and جذيانون. As for جذعون, جذعون, I have written it جذعون to mention to you, brothers, the word Jid'un. Jid'un, I came with it to show you the difference between Jid'un and Jada'un. So Jada'un is a youngster. As for Jid'un, is a trunk of a tree. Okay. والجمعُ جذوعٌ. Okay. Tree trunks is جذوعٌ. Okay. So we know we have done ورقةٌ before. This is a trunk of a tree, a trunk. And the last thing we have in a tree, or the last important thing, is the branches. Okay, is the branches of the tree. And that is غصنٌ. غصنٌ غين صاد نون. غصنٌ is the branch of a tree. والجمع أغصانٌ بهمزة القطع. أغصانٌ. بهمزة القطع والمفرد بدون نقطة without dot غصن صاد غصن أغصان. إذن أيها الإخوة هذا ما يتعلق بكلمة غصن. نعم ليتني فيها. Then so he said then ليتني أكون حيا. I wished I would be alive then. Okay, so he used later with جدعون. That shows you the impossibility. He's an old man and he wished to become young again. He wished to become young in this life to help the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he will be expelled. So that's why later, laytani akunu hayyan. Maybe he saw it as something. He didn't know when he will die, but he was maybe so old that he saw or he suggested that he might be dead at that time. Okay, so that's why he didn't maybe use the word the harf la'alla. Laytani akunu hayya. I wish I would be from kana yakunu. I wish I was alive. So hayyun hayyun is alive. Hayyun is alive, and one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-hayy. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي الحي القيوم. نعم. Okay. So حي ما عكس حي. What is the opposite of حي? He is alive. Is هو حي. And he is dead. هو ميت. ميت. وجمع حي هو حي. هم أحياء. هم أحياء. And as أريد أن أتأكد. I just want to double check if it's not ممنوع من الصرف. لا, it's not ممنوع من الصرف. بل أحياء ولكن لا تشعرون. So let's mention the Quran. بل أحياء ولكن لا تشعرون. When Allah سبحانه وتعالى spoke about those who died in the path of Allah, that don't think that they are dead. Rather, بل أحياء ولكن لا تشعرون. But you don't feel that. يعني we don't know about that. Okay. So أحياءٌ here is in the Quran also with double dhamma, so it's not ممنوع من الصرف. So جمع حيٌ is أحياءٌ. أحياءٌ. And حيٌ also means area, and the plural is also أحياءٌ, يعني areas. Okay, so حيٌ is an area as you know, or a neighborhood, as you know, والجمع أحياء كذلك. So it's the same singular and same plural, والله أعلم. But for female, we don't use حي. What is قبل ذلك, before that, ما جمع ميت أموات. Dead people أهم أموات. أموات. طيب للمؤنث, how do we say for the female, she is alive, هي حية. بالتاء المربوطة ويا مشددة. يا مشددة يعني يا متشددة, حية. And هن, they female are alive, هن, they for female, هن حيات. والله أعلم. حية also means what? حية means snake. And also حية is snakes. So حية is also snake. So depends, بحسب السياق, depends on the context. And there is also another word for snake, very known. ثعبان, also mentioned in the Quran. It's also another word for snake. ثعبان. ثعبان أن حية. طيب بعد ذلك أيها الإخوة, عندنا نعم, we have done غصن أغصان branch branches. نعم, إذ يخرجك قومك. What's إذ أيها الإخوة؟ إذ مرادف لي is similar as حيث, what means when. Okay, إذ and حيث مرادفتان, they mean the same thing. And إذ is a ظرف زمان, is a ظرف زمان, so it's مفعول فيه, مبني على السكون في محل نصب. Okay. And it comes in a جملة فعلية, in a جملة اسمية. It comes before a nominal sentence, before a verbal sentence. نعم. نعم. And it comes قبل الفعل الماضي والمضارع. It can comes إذ يخرجك, إذ أخرجك. Okay. So it means when. مثل حيث. إذ يخرجك قومك. ما معنى يخرج من أخرج يخرج إخراجا أخرج. So we have فعل لازم and we have فعل متعد. فعل لازم, no مفعول به needed, no object. And فعل متعد, you use always object. So the فعل لازم is خرج. He himself went out. So you say خرج. إذا قلت خرج سعيد يمكنك and تنتهي بنقطة. You can stop with a full stop. خرج سعيد بس, that's it. خرج سعيد. But the, so this خرج يخرج أخرج بهمزة الوصل وضمة خروجا هو المصدر, فهو خارج. He's coming out, going out. واسم المفعول والله أعلم مخروج. Okay. Now we have the الفعل المتعدي الذي معنا الآن that we have here. And that is أخرج, to take somebody out or to take someone out. Okay? So أخرج سعيد خالدا من البيت. أخرج سعيد, سعيد took out خالد from the house. So he took him out of the house. So أخرج سعيد مالا. سعيد took out money from his pocket. سعيد أخرج مالا من جيبه. So he took out. So that is using أخرج with the object. We just used before أخرج with person. So أخرج سعيد خالدا من البيت. أخرج سعيد مالا من جيبه. So أخرج يخرج أخرج بهمزة القطع في الأمر. والمصدر إخراجا بهمزة القطع أيضا. So when you find همزة القطع in the past tense, you will find it also in the مصدر. أخرج يخرج أخرج إخراجا فهو مخرج. He's the one that takes out. واسم المفعول. So we had that was the اسم الفاعل مخرج واسم المفعول مخرج. That is the person you taking out or the object that you are taking out. That's مخرج. نعم. إد إذ يخرجك قومك. وقوم is a people or nation. Okay. قوم is a people. قوم لوط, the people of لوط. قوم هود, the people of هود. إذ يخرجك قومك. وجمع قوم, what's the peoples? أقوام. Okay. Peoples or nations. أقوام بهمزة القطع. أقوام with a strong همزة. أقوام. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أو مخرجيهم. We have done مخرجون. What is اسم الفاعل? Is the person that takes out. And the ya is my. Are they taking me out? يعني هم, them, are they taking me out? Okay. And awa, you know, the awa is, you know, the, it has to do with the questioning. The a, I'm sure that's the questioning tool. Harfu istifham is the letter of questioning. We have two a and hal. Both are letters. Adatu istifhamin, questioning tools. Or harfu istifham because it's a letter as well, and the wa I'm not sure what the exactly role is. Hadafu harf al waw huna wallahu alam. But the meaning here awa mukhrijiyahum is will they drive me out, will they take me out or drive me out. Now the best translation maybe here in this context, will they drive me out. Okay, so it's اسم فاعل من أخرج. أخرج يخرج فهو مخرج. So أو مخرجيهم, are they going to drive me out? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't know, otherwise he would not ask that. And this is not a story just to read. This story is صحيح البخاري. As you can see after a few lines between the two brackets, صحيح البخاري. So أو مخرجيهم مخرج. The word mukhrijun has also another meaning, and that is a producer. Okay, if you think about cinema or movie makers, the producer is mukhrijun. I just give you that information so you know what it means when you hear it. Okay, I'm not calling to anything. I just gave you the information. Okay, and a Muslim has to know the good and the bad. Okay. The Muslim has to know the good and the bad. And Hudayfa radiallahu anhu, he used to ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about ashar, about the bad things, so he could protect himself from falling in it. So a person who does not know a shirk, he might fall in it. A person who doesn't know al-kufr, he might fall in it and he doesn't know. So that is the issue of mukhrijun. Okay? Our mukhrijiya hum. So sometimes I explain things in the book, it doesn't mean that I call to it, but I teach you that so you know what it is when you hear it, whether it's in the street, whether it's anywhere where you read it. Our mukhrijiya hum. همزة علامة استفهام punctuation marks as from the علامة الترقيم. قال, and then we have the two dots, what's called نقطتان, as you can remember, كما تذكرون. نعم, ثم have we have another punctuation mark, and that is فاصلة منقوطة. Okay, semicolon. لم يأتي رجل قط بمثل ما جئت به إلا عوديا إلا عوديا. لم يأتي, لم يأتي رجل قط. قط اسم ممنوع من الصرف. It's only one ضمة. It's always قط. Okay, it's not قطي or قطة. It's just مبني. It's fixed. مبني like that. And نعم. قط أيها الإخوة، حاولوا أن تترجموا معي. Try to translate with me. ظرف زمان. قط ظرف زمان. Okay. So it's مفعول فيه. And it's time related. ظرف زمان زمان للماضي. It's for the past tense. Okay. وتختص بالنفي. It's specific for النفي for negating. تختص بتصادد أنت مشددة. تختص تا خا تا صاد مشددة. تختص بالنفي. It's only for negating. متى؟ When in the past tense. We use قط. ما ذهبت إلى هنا قط. I've never been here before. ما أكلت هذا قط. I never ate this before. And some of the people, they make a mistake by using abadan. Abadan is same. It's ظرف زمان. It's also للنفي. It's negating. But one difference. هناك فرق واحد. Abadan with the همزة القطع. Ba, da, ba, dal. همزة القطع. Ba, dal. And alif mamduda. Abadan is for negating in the future tense. Okay. لن أزورك أبدا. لا نون. لن will never visit you. لن أزورك أبدا. Okay. لا آتي إلى هنا أبدا. I will never come here again. And in future, you're negating for the future. But قط I haven't visited him ever. ما زرته قط. Okay. فهو مبني على الضم في محل نصب ظرف زمان. So it's fixed on a dhamma and it's in a position of mansub because it's ظرف زمان. And abadan, abadan has two meanings. Abadan is never, and abadan is also ever. Just extra information. Although I know we don't do the abadan now, but khalidina fiha abadan, always. But when it comes with negating, then it's never in the future tense. Okay, brothers in Islam. So abadan, it can also mean ever, as I just explained. So. نعود إلى النص. Going back to the text. لم يأتي رجل قط بمثل ما جئت به إلا عوديا. No man haven't come. There is no man that haven't come with the same thing as you came with it, except that he was عوديا. عوديا يعني he was shown enmity. Okay. He was shown enmity. So that's the meaning of it. Because lam, when it comes in a present tense, it gives past tense meaning. Lam yati, didn't come. From أتى همزة القطع تاء ألف مقصورة أتى أتيت I came أتيت يأتي ائتي إتيانا بهمزة القطع فهو آت تاء بكسرتين اسم الفاعل ما معنى عودية أنا ذكرت لكم ذلك قبل قليل أولا هناك آه معان مختلفة, there are different meanings when it comes to that word. أولا هناك كلمة مشهورة, this famous word, and that is عود. What is عود أيها الإخوة؟ عود or العود, العود or عود. عود is same as خشب, it's also same as خشب. Okay, يعني عود is same as خشب. عود is wood, just like خشب. خشب عود is wood, and عود is also the very famous wooden sticks that you burn, and you get a very beautiful perfume smell of it. Okay, you have to burn that with coals, small wooden sticks called عودون. It's very expensive, it's been sold with grams, and that's also عودون, and they also make it fluid, from it fluid perfume, very strong and very nice عودون. So عودون and خشبون is wood. Okay, طيب. And then we have a verb we have another verb, and it has nothing to do with the verb we have now, with the noun we have now, that's عودية, and that is عادة. What is عادة? عادة, I give you some of the verbs that are close to it, so you don't mix them up, inshallah. عادة is مثل مرادف لي رجع, same as رجع, is to return. عادة سعيد, رجع سعيد, he came back, to return, he returned, he came back. عدت, I came back. عدت. المضارع, he's coming back, يعود, he will come back, سيعود. عاد يعود, عد, عين دال ساكنة, عد. For females, عودي, okay. والمصدر عود أو عودا, okay. وهناك مصدر آخر عودة, so we have عودا and we have عودة, both mean return, returning, okay. فهو عائد, so he's returning, هو عائد بالهمزة على الكرسي, وهي عائدة بالدال والتاء المربوطة, اسم الفاعل. Okay, الآن عندنا الفعل الذي يخصنا, الفعل الذي يخصنا, the verb that concerns us, خص يخص with صاد, خاء and صاد, خص, شاء صاد مشددة, خاء يخصني, it concerns me, and that is the verb عادة بعين ألف دال ألف مقصورة. عادة, to show enmity towards. عادة, عادة, عاديت, I showed enmity towards, towards. عاديته, I showed enmity towards him. عاداني, he showed enmity towards me. عادة, يعادي, المضارع داليا, الأمر عادي, دال مكسورة بدون يا. نعم, والمصدر enmity, okay, hostility or hostile, hostility is معاداة, وهناك مصدر آخر that's عداء, so معاداة, معاداة ب ميم عين ألف دال ألف تاء مربوطة, معاداة. وكذلك عداء, عين دال ألف همزة على السطر, همزة على السطر, enmity, عداء or عداء. Okay. سبحان الله ورق بن نوفل said that nobody hasn't come, no man hasn't come ever with the same that you have come with except that enmity was shown towards him. Okay, عودية هذا فعل ماض مبني للمجهول. This مبني من للمجهول where the فاعل is not known. The one that shows enmity is not known. That's why it's مبني للمجهول of the verb عادة. So عادة is the مبني للمعلوم, the standard verb. It's like أكل and أكل. أكل he ate, أكل has been eaten. Okay. ضرب he hit and ضرب he was hit. So it's not known who hit him. Okay, except that he was shown enmity towards. It didn't mention who showed the enmity towards him, but he said that it will happen. And then he said, وَإِنْ يُدْرِكْنِي يَوْمُكَ أَنْصُرْكَ نَصْرًا مُؤَزَّرًا نَصْرًا مُؤَزِّرًا. So he said, وَإِنْ يُدْرِكْنِي يَوْمُكَ, if your day reach me, if your day reaches me, okay, so in, if, in means if, and in is a powerful harf, because it's adatu shartin, it's a tool of condition. What makes يعني هذا الأداتو وهذه الأداتو تجزم فعلين مضارعين. It makes two present tense verbs مجزوم. It gives them both سكون. Okay. إن يأكل آكل. If he eats, I eat. Okay. So it's أداتو شرط condition. And the فعل شرط, the verb of condition is the first verb. So the first verb is a condition for the second verb. If he eats, then I eat. So the condition is that he has to eat first. Okay? Okay? إن يخرج أخرج. If he goes out, I go out. So both verbs are مجزوم. Look how powerful one harf has done to two present tense verbs. Okay? So it's أداتو شرط. تجزم فعلين. And the first fi'l, as you know, is called fi'lu shartin. And the second one is jawabu shartin. Jawabu shartin. Yani it's a response of the condition of the first verb. What is the condition? Jawabu shartin. Naam. So harfu shartin is in. Okay. Harfu shartin jazimin. Harfu shartin jazimin. It makes majzum. Just like lam and la and nahiya and lamul amr. Naam. وَإِن مَبْنِيٌ عَلَى السُّكُونَ and لَا مَحَلَّ لَهُ مِنَ الْإِعْرَابِ. It has no position in الْإِعْرَابِ. It's not a فاعل مفعول به or مبتدا. It's a حرف. It's just, it's a حرف. But although that, it has an influence. Just like حروف الجر have also influence. But this one has influence on two present tense verbs. It's called أَدَاتُ شَرْطِين. And that's why, what do we find after in? وَإِنْ يُدْرِكْنِي, normally it's أَدْرَكَ يُدْرِكُ. أَدْرَكَ, he reached. أَدْرَكْتُ الصَّلَاةَ, I reached the prayer. Okay. أَدْرَكَ يُدْرِكُ is also to understand. أَدْرَكْتُ is also to comprehend. Okay. And to understand. Okay. أَدْرَكْتُ الْمَسْأَلَةَ, I understood the issue. Like فَهِمْتُ, فَهِمَ يَفْهَمُ فَهْمًا. It's also to reach. وَإِنْ يُدْرِكْنِي قَوْمُكَ. It's normally أَدْرَكَ يُدْرِكُ إِدْرَاكًا. But here it's يُدْرِك مَجْزُوم because of إِنْ. وَإِنْ يُدْرِكْنِي, if it reach me, يَوْمُكَ, your day, يعني when that will happen. And the noon is نُونُ الْوِقَايَ of يُدْرِكْنِي. So you see here two sukuns. The kaf ends on sukun. And the ya, what is damirun muttasil, is also sukun, sakinun. So the noon is between them. وإن يدركني يومك, if your day will reach me, أنصرك, this is the جواب شرط. What's the condition? If it reach me, the جواب شرط أنصرك. I will from نصر ينصر. What's نصر ينصر؟ أنصر نصرا. Okay. فهو ناصر واسم المفعول منصور. Okay. So نصر is to assist. Okay. To support. نعم support. نعم. So he will, he said, if that day will reach me, I will support you نصرا مؤزرا. Okay, I will support you. So نصر, as he supported, نصر ينصر, أنصر نصرا. فهو ناصر, he is a supporter, and منصور is the one that is being supported. Okay, the one that's being helped and support, the one that is being supported now. Now, and that's why we find that Al-Ansar, they were the supporters of the Muhajirin, and before that the Prophet ﷺ, the Ansar. And the Ansar, بهمزه القطع, Ansarun, هذا جمع ناصر. It's from the ism al-fa'il, ناصر, what is the supporter. نعم. And the meaning of sa nam, the meaning of ansurka nasran muazziran, I will support you, a support what is strong, a steady support. And it's like an emphasis, okay? Because a muazziran is also from the word, from the fi'l madi azara bil mad, azara afwan, نعم من فعل أزر بهمزة القطع زا مشددة را. أزر يؤزر, the واو with همزة, الهمزة above the واو, يؤزر أزر بهمزة القطع زا مشددة را ساكنة, تأزيرا. Okay, that's also support. أزر مثل نصر, to support. أزر يؤزر أزر تأزيرا فهو مؤزر, he's a supporter. Okay. واسم المفعول مؤزر. So أزر سعيد خالدا, دعمه وقواه, he supported him. وهناك فعل آخر مرادف, and that's أزر يؤزر, same like أزر يؤزر. أزر بالمد, يؤزر يا واو بالهمزة فوق الواو, وألف يؤازر, آزر مؤازرة, فهو مؤازر بالهمزة على الواو. واسم المفعول مؤازر كذلك بالهمزة على الواو. So also supporting, يعني okay. آزر سعيد خالدا, يعني ساعده وناصره, يعني he helped him, he supported him and helped him. نعم. So نعم. And finally, أيها الإخوة, ثم لم ينشب ورقة أن توفي. لم ينشب ورقة أن توفي. And إن شاء الله we will end here إن شاء الله, and we'll complete this next lesson. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.